You're welcome to the First Pentecostal Church, Villarica.
Mother-in-law of Evelyn Hux, and Wesley Poss, grandson of Evelyn Hupp. Fred and Alan Wicks, parents of Thomas Wicks. Max and Dorothy Seals, parents of Susan Wicks. Theo and Grace Wicks, grandparents of Thomas Wicks. Judy Seals Bailey, sister of Susan Wicks. George and Elfie Allen, grandparents of Eddie Allen and Susan Wicks. J.P. and Pearl Seals, grandparents of Susan Wicks. Buford Tidwell, grandparent of Thomas Wicks. Gladys Wheeler, grandparent of Thomas Wicks. William and Eunice Woodley, parents of Vic Woodley. John Woodley, brother of Vic Woodley. J.W. and Bassie Ward, parents of Sybil Woodley. Bernice Sutton, aunt of Sybil Woodley. J.D. Watson, my father. Jacob and Jonathan Watson, nephews of mine and Eddie. Adam Ball, father of Logan Ball. Jack Bryant, father of Rowdy Bryant. W.T. and Irene Moses, parents of Anita Bryant. Shirley Roberts, sister of Anita Bryant. Charles Allen, husband of Kay Allen. And P.C. and I. Bailey, founders of the church. There are many more, but nobody gave me names to read, so that's it.
Thank you, Sister Penny. Can we all stand in a moment of silence for those dearly beloved, the saints, the names that you had, and also if you have someone also that has departed, let us bow our heads.
You're messing with my life, too. But what about the family? How's it going to affect them?
It's
It's not going to affect them at all if you keep your big mouth shut. If no one will know unless you tell. It's a perfect secret. There's no way anyone will ever find out unless you open your big mouth.
You know you're wrong. Now I know about it. Now I'm part of it. But worst of all, God knows about it, Adam.
Oh, I know he knows about it. You know, I think he's part of the reason why I did it. Because he's constantly punishing me for everything I do wrong. Just the stress of all this punishment just made me not care. I didn't even care.
You're like, you did this, no one else. Adam, you got to man up and take responsibility for your actions. Do you realize that even though we left the church, God has always been there for us? He's provided for our every need. You have no excuse for what you've done. And he's not blaming us. He's not punishing us. He loves us more than ever.
Oh, I know. I know. It's my fault. It's always my fault. And you know, I'm just tired of dealing with it. I'm tired of dealing with everything. It's the stress of life is just too much for me to handle. And you know what? I'm done talking about this too. Do whatever you have to do. If you have to tell everybody, if that makes you feel better, then tell everybody. But I'm done talking about
it. I'm not going to tell anyone. Adam, come back. Don't walk away.
I have nothing else to say about this.
You can't fix this by running away.
Lori, I thought that was you.
Hey.
You okay? I know we haven't worked together very long, but I've noticed lately you just seem so upset. And that man, was he bothering you? Did he hurt you?
No, hi, Elaine. That was my husband, Adam. You see, he's done something, and now we've got a big problem, and we don't know what to do about it.
You don't know how to handle it. It's just too much right now. It's too much. Is there someone? Do you want to talk?
Elaine, I couldn't talk to you about this.
Oh, I don't mean for you to tell me everything. I just want you to know that you're not alone. I know you have family and friends that would be more than glad to help. But, Lori, you have someone that's so much more precious. You have Jesus.
Well, I'm I don't know what to do. Adam and I used to be in church. A lot of that church over there. We haven't been in so long, we've just fallen. Just so back out of church. I don't know what to do.
But you're not alone. Or you're not alone. You have Jesus. He's here to help you. No matter what you're facing.
I know. He provides mercy, grace, forgiveness. But Elaine, you don't know what's happened. You don't know what's been done. He could never forgive us for something like this.
Oh, yes. Let me tell you something about Jesus. He let us hold and it's changed my life forever. Did you notice the cross and the tomb?
Yes.
My church put that here for everyone that passes by to be reminded of all the sacrifice that Jesus has done for us. That cross, he hung on that cross and he shed his precious blood. For our sins, so we might one day be in heaven with him. And the tomb, that represents who he was buried. But Lord, he's not there. He's alive. He's alive, and he's here to help you. He's forgiven us all for in peace. Please, Lord, just turn your heart to him.
Thank you. good. When I slipped away, it became more like torture. Week after week, I would go listen to those sermons the preacher preached, and I felt like there was just a target on my chest. It was so uncomfortable, and it got to the point where I didn't even want to go anymore. So I stopped. Remember those sermons that the preacher preached? How did he know? How did he know what I'd done? How did he know what I was doing? How did he know that I needed to hear a message of repentance? How did he know I'd gone so far astray? And yet every time, after the service was over, he'd shake my hand and tell me how much Jesus loved me. How much did he want it to make a difference in my life? But I ignored it. I ignored it, and I walked away and continued going down the path that I always had. I don't know. I used to believe that Jesus loved me. I used to think that was true. But not now. Who are you?
I'm just someone the Lord has said to remind you of His great love. To let you know that you're not alone. Adam, these things you're going through are not for your harm, but for your salvation.
Oh, I doubt God's interested in saving me. He knows all about what I've done. And I hate to waste your time, but I've gone too far. I've done too much. I'm not worth saving. There's no way God would ever forgive someone like me. There's no way He would ever forgive what I've done.
But I thought the same. Yeah, but I thought the same thing. I thought surely God was done with me. You know, we went to the garden. Jesus asked us to wait and pray. But we fell asleep. And when He returned, He said, could you not stay awake for at least 1 hour and pray with me? And then as He left me go again, He asked us to watch and pray that we would not be led into temptation. But Adam, we couldn't do it. We failed at such a simple task.
I'm telling you, it's just too late for me. The damage that I've done can't be undone. There's nothing that can make it right. It's just, I'm lost, and He's done with me.
Well, I remember a time before.
Then Jesus came with them to a place called Gethsemane.
Sit here while I go and pray over there.
And He took with Him Peter and the two sons of Zebedee, and He began to be sorrowful, deeply distressed.
My soul is exceedingly sorrowful, even to death. Stay here and watch with me.
He went a little farther and fell on His face.
Oh, my Father, if it is possible, let this cup pass from me. Nevertheless, not as I will, but as You will.
Then He came to the disciples and found them sleeping. And said to Peter,
what? Could you not watch with me 1 hour? Watch and pray, lest you enter into temptation. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak.
Again, a second time, He went away and prayed.
Oh, my Father, this cup cannot pass away from me unless I drink it. Your will be done.
And He came and found them asleep again, for their eyes were heavy. So He left them, went away again, and prayed the third time, saying the same words. came to his disciples and said to them,
"Are you still sleeping and resting? Behold, the hour is at hand, and the Son of Man is being betrayed to the hands of sinners. Rise, let us be going. See, my betrayer is at hand."
As I spoke earlier, repentance will awaken a sleeping soul. You will find grace sufficient enough at the cross to cover all your sins. That what Jesus wants to forgive you. Yes. He wants to use you for his glory. He wants to reinstate everything about you.
You don't understand. I've done too much. I've hurt people that I love. I've hurt complete strangers that didn't even know. They don't know. I've lost everything. My wife don't trust me. And there's no reason for her to. I've done too much. I've gone too far.
Jesus sacrificed everything for you. He paid your sin debt before. He took your place. He suffered your shame. I remember as they took him. He was beaten. He was ridiculed. He was spit upon.
Thank you.
endure such a person like me? Will you forgive me? I'm so sorry. That's not the man I want to be. I'm so ashamed, God. I want to be forgiven. I want to be delivered from this horrible bondage. I don't want to live in sin any longer. I don't want to run from you anymore, God. I know now that those messages the preacher preached, they were for me. You were trying to use him to reach me before it was too late, before it got this bad. I didn't listen, God, but I'm listening now. You have my attention, God. Created me a clean heart and a right spirit, God. Help me to be loyal to you. Save my soul from eternal separation. But not just my soul, God, but my life completely. I surrender all. I surrender all to you. I need your grace. I'm nothing without. I accept Jesus. I accept the beat that he took for me. I'm thankful, God, that he endured it so that I can be made free. God, let your light shine through me. Use this situation, God, to deter others from going down this road. Let my life be a light. Turn this horrible situation into a testimony for your glory. God, as you forgive me, I pray that you would help my wife forgive me as well. Help my children forgive me. God, I pray that our relationships will be restored. I pray that I could be the husband that you have been me. I pray to be the father that you have been me. God, I pray that you help me. Because without your help, I can't do it. I know I'm forgiven. I know the sins that I've committed have been cast away. Because you have borne my griefs and you have carried my sorrows far away. And I thank you for your grace. Truly, God, there is no sin that I've committed that's greater than your grace. I am yours, Lord. I am yours. In Jesus' name.
Be merciful to me, O Lord, for I cry to you all day long. Rejoice the soul of your servant, for to you, O Lord, I lift up my soul. For you, Lord, are good and ready to forgive and abundant in mercy to all those who call upon you. Give ear, O Lord, to my prayer and attend to the voice of my supplications. In the day of my trouble, I will call upon you, for you will answer me.
Forward. I want us to be in agreement together.
also many other things that Jesus did, which if they were written one by one, I suppose that even the world itself could not contain the books that would be written. Amen.
They're very humble, and they're, even though they come out and perform, they
really do not do it for self-recognition. But we want to call them out, if we would. I'll have all of them come out and we'll announce them as they come. You have them on your program. Let me just kind of reiterate that they're coming out, some of them in the sound booth. Yes, Adam is out of prison. Lori was Lori Covington. Elaine was Elaine Spear. Prophet was Jim Spear. Jesus was Chase Rice. The Shadow Box. What the Shadow Box, very, very good. Then in the Shadow Box cast was Logan Teal, Will Parks, Dickie Parks, Jacob Parks, and Mindy Teal. The lights and the sounds were handled by Kevin Parks, Art Vita, Autumn Rice. Beautiful music was presented by Sister Jennifer Staten, and the vocals were Jennifer Staten and Art Vita. Here's up there in the sound booth. Give them a hand. Excellent job. We're so very proud of each and every one of you. And thank you for coming. And a very happy Easter to you all. I hear the raindrops gently falling on the roof, so be careful as you go. We will be dismissing in just a few moments. If you have offering or time today that you want to give, we'll have some ushers standing by the door. I do want to make this announcement tonight at 6 o'clock. In the sanctuary, we will be having a communion service to commemorate not only the Last Supper, but the death, the burial, and the resurrection of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. If you've never attended a communion service, that is a very, very moving ministry, and we look forward to that tonight. So it will be at 6 o'clock here in the main sanctuary at First Meeting Gospel Church. If you would stand, we will dismiss you. God bless you. Thank you for coming. Father, again, we just want to thank you for your many blessings. Thank you, Lord, for the drama. Thank you for the presentation, God, that has brought to our memory, Lord, the great and crucial price that Christ paid on the cross of Calvary for our sins. Father, we thank you that when we are so burdened down, when we do seem like there's no way out, we can come to you. Your grace is sufficient. Father, we pray a very special blessing and an anointing upon every family member here today. Lord, I pray that you would protect us. I pray that your Holy Spirit would lead and guide us. I pray that we will always remember what you did on the cross of the Calvary, not just one day of the year, but each and every day. We give you our heartfelt thanks. God bless the trauma ministry. God bless each and every one who did this today. Keep us safe. So we meet again. We give you the praise, the honor, and glory. We ask you in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. We love you.